You'd feel he's in the building. He's somewhere.
Bam! He'd blast through the fucking door.
We're gonna make you a star, kid.
He's always looking for something that somebody hasn't heard yet.
He had the energy of a rock drummer.
Max! It's Michael Gudinski, how are you?
In the late 60s, radio had hardly any Australian content. I couldn't understand why people weren't supporting their own war. That's why Mushroom started.
The whole evolution of Australian music is about to erupt.
The first few years of Mushroom, there was a crazy risk.
People said, oh, this isn't going to work. If he had faith in it, the more it drove him.
He has been so influential in an entire continent's music scene. That's how expansive he was as a human being.
I imagine being a rock promoter as the biggest fucking nightmare. There has to be a reason why he did it.
I'd just like to see that more Australian artists get the chance to break overseas.
He had something he wanted to prove to himself.
Maybe it's an addiction of some sort, never stopping trying to make it happen for someone.
There was every chance that I could have been another one that had gone off the rails. But we give it everything we've got. When I get obsessed, I don't like losing.
He came on strong, you know.
His biggest strength was his ability to connect with artists.
Gudinski, where are you?
Yes!
Let's have a big cheer for Mr. Gudinski!
Long live Australian rock and roll, thank you.
Here we go.